Okay, we're live. Oh, wait, maybe are we not? Still the circle's going. There we go. All right, so it is Wednesday, April 8th, and we're going to do our third installment of creating paleo art with on behalf of Field Station Dinosaurs. And today, as you guys know, there we go. If you've been paying attention online, you'd know that we had a vote for the animal that was going to be portrayed today, and it was between two really popular dinosaurs. It was between Triceratops and Stegosaurus, which are two dinosaurs that everybody knows, I think. And I was actually surprised. I thought Triceratops was going to win, but apparently you guys like Stegosaurus more. I personally like Triceratops, but we'll do Stegosaurus. Stegosaurus is cool too. So, a little bit about Stegosaurus before we start. Like I said, this is a very popular dinosaur. Most people know it. It's from North America, Western North America, and it lived during the late Jurassic, about roughly 150 million years ago. And that's important because the last two dinosaurs that we've done, Tyrannosaurus rex and Parasaurolophus, were not from the Jurassic. They were from the Cretaceous. They were much younger. In fact, Tyrannosaurus rex is closer in time to today than it is to Stegosaurus. Okay, it's something that a lot of people don't realize. If a lot of people imagine, some people think that all dinosaurs just coexist with each other, all prehistoric dinosaurs. Like you'd have T-Rex and Stegosaurus and Brachiosaurus all walking around together. That's not the case. So Stegosaurus actually never would have met Tyrannosaurus rex nor Triceratops. It lived at the same time and place as other popular dinosaurs, though, like Brontosaurus and Apatosaurus. Though we used to think those were the same thing, they're actually two different kinds of dinosaurs. You can say Brontosaurus; that's allowed now. Brachiosaurus was around. Allosaurus was around. If you know Allosaurus, it's another meat eater known for having three big claws on its hands. So that was a different community of dinosaurs than what Tyrannosaurus rex was living in, and also from what Parasaurolophus was living in. Okay, Stegosaurus is known for having a tiny, teeny, tiny little head, so small. Okay, and all these huge plates on the back. The plates were kind of diamond shaped, and for a long time, scientists didn't really know what they were. When they first discovered Stegosaurus, some scientists thought that the plates would be flat on the back, giving it like armor, like an armadillo. Some scientists thought that the plates would stick out to the sides more. Now we're pretty sure they were sticking out of the back like this. And the tail, of course, had these four huge spikes sticking out of the back that it would have used for protection. Now, this is just a toy, and the toy is actually a little bit outdated. We now know that Stegosaurus looked a little different from this. It turns out its neck was a little bit longer, and its tail was a little bit longer, and the center of gravity where its hips would have been a little bit lower, and we're going to show that in our drawing today. Don't forget to comment during the process because I like to see questions and comments on Instagram. I'm going to try to do the same thing. Let's see. Yep, there's some people joining in on Instagram. That's cool. I'm doing Instagram at the same time this time. Okay. I'm going to set that up like this. There we go. Just like that's fine. Okay, great. So let's get started. So I'm going to rotate my camera like this. I'm going to rotate my paper like that. And we're going to get started. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to do the Stegosaurus in a little bit of a different pose. Last time we did the Parasaurolophus just straight up, like from the side. And that's an easy one to do a lot of the time. So we're actually going to do something different. I'm going to do this a little bit more interesting of a pose. So I'm going to start off by doing the Stegosaurus's head. And Stegosaurus's head is actually going to be facing to the right of my paper. But the rest of the body is still going to be facing up. So his head or her head is going to be kind of turned to the side. And Stegosaurus's head was like a wedge. It had a long pointy nose and it was kind of like slender from side to side. So the way I'm going to draw this is I'm going to draw kind of like a sideways triangle And if you ever practice drawing 3D shapes, that's kind of what it's going to be. So you can see it up here up close on Instagram, and I think Facebook, we can see it's like a sideways triangle. It kind of looks like a block of cheese. That's kind of how I compare it. And then I'm going to start doing the details. So there's going to be an eye socket, a circle for the eye socket. That's where the eye is going to go. The snout is going to turn down. Has a little bit of a beak in the front, the lower jaw. I'm going to take my eraser and I'm going to just get rid of all these extra lines that I made when I was sketching it. And again, sometimes people ask me, how do you do that? You make it look so easy. Well, it's just practice. It's a lot of practice. Okay. Filling my eyeball. The nostril is going to go here. And remember, just like with Paraspheralophus, this guy had a little bit of a beak, so it would have made the snout a little bit longer. And here we have our cute little Stegosaurus head. So you can see that there. There we go. Whoop, uh-oh. Get rid of that. I accidentally hit a button on my computer. There we go. Cool. So I gotta put my phone somewhere. Hard to do them both at the same time. There we go. Cool. All right. So now I'm gonna start putting in the rest of the body. So to do that, it's gonna be real simple, real light at first. I'm drawing kind of like a swirly shape around the head. That's gonna be the neck. The neck is going to go up here. It's going to go into the shoulders. This is what we call the shoulder girdle. So I'm drawing like a circle here where the arms are going to come out. Going to put one arm there. Our thigh is going to go there, the knee, calf, foot. I'm going to kind of make it like the Stegosaurus is kind of swishing its tail to the side. So the tail is going to kind of curve downward. There we go. Right, there's the other arm is going to go here. The other leg is going to kind of be behind our first leg. Remember, with the Paraspheralophus, the legs aren't, they don't walk parallel. So if the front arm is forward, the leg on the same side is going to be back. Okay. Cool. Let's see, do we have any questions yet? Nope, not yet. I don't see any. Guys, if you have a question, ask it. Goodness gracious, it's not hard. Anyway, don't be afraid to ask questions. That's why I'm here. So, yeah, let's start with the body and then we'll go into the plates and the spikes, the fun stuff later. All right, so I'm going to start with this neck. So a thing about Stegosaurus that maybe you didn't know is that it had armor on the bottom of its neck. Everyone knows that Stegosaurus had plates and spikes. But we also know that they had armor on the neck. Someone asked, did they have a keratinous beak? Yes, anything with a beak, the beak would have been made of keratin. So just like Paraspheralophus or Triceratops or a turtle or any kind of bird, there would have been a layer of keratin out there. But anyway, keratin is the same stuff that your fingernails are made of, also horns and beaks in nature. So it had armor on the bottom of its neck. So it actually would have had like kind of like a throat pouch, like a saggy little dangly part under its neck. And there would have been little armor chunks. And we know this, and I'm drawing these armor chunks in now, like little circles. We actually know this because they were found with the fossil, with the skeleton. And what's cool is the first Stegosaurus that was found, we call it the holotype, died, and it was kind of undisturbed. So it wasn't just a bunch of jumbled up bones. It died in the paleontologist found it in the pose that it died in. So all these little armor things were in the neck region, we know they were in the neck region and not somewhere else in the body. And Stegosaurus probably had these because for protection. It already had that nice spiky tail in the back, but it needed a way to protect the front of its body. So if it got bit on the neck, which is the go-to place for lots of dinosaurs to attack, like meat eaters, like Allosaurus, that would have been a good place to bite them. Well, if you had armor there, it might save your life. Some people are asking me to slow down. Sorry, guys. I go fast because I'm so used to doing this. I do this like second nature. So I'll try my best to slow down a little bit. Also, the time where I pause to like tell you about the dinosaur, that hopefully is a good time for you to catch up if you're trying to follow along exactly. But also keep in mind, you don't need to follow along exactly to what I'm doing, right? You can do your own version of this dinosaur. That's totally cool and acceptable. I wonder if I'm allowed to do this. I think Instagram will let me do that. I hope so. If I do it sideways on Instagram, does it show up? I don't want it to be like wonky the whole time. Yeah, let's keep it right side up just to be safe. I'll see in the we'll see in later on. Okay, so so then we have, so here I'll show you up close. So there's like some little armor plating underneath the neck. You can see it looks like little pebbles embedded in the skin there. All right, so the neck is going to go down here. Remember, the neck of Stegosaurus was pretty long. Wasn't as long as like a sauropod, but it was pretty long. It doesn't look as long because it turned to the side, but it did have a pretty long neck. And then I'm going to draw the chest and where the shoulders are. Here's the upper arm. We're going to talk about the upper arm in a minute. Here's the elbow. And just like Parasaurolophus, remember we talked about how many dinosaurs kind of walked on their fingers? Okay. So Stegosaurus didn't walk flat on its hand. It walked up on its fingers. So the wrist would have been like a joint that would have helped it walk. And as for the hands, if I'm not mistaken, I think Stegosaurus only had two claws on each hand. I think the other ones were kind of like those little nubs. So there's the two claws for the one hand. Okay. Fun thing about the upper arm, Stegosaurus had very special upper arm bones. It had a very flexible upper arm, and that is because it had the ability, we now know, to rotate its whole body pretty quickly. So I can use this guy as a demonstration. So if Stegosaurus was feeling threatened by a predator, say an Allosaurus or something was coming after him, he could put his weight on the front limbs and swing the body around like that. And the reason why Stegosaurus would have wanted to do that is because it wanted to face the dangerous tail part towards the predator. It didn't want its head facing the predator. It wanted the tail facing the predator. So it was able to rotate on its front legs more easily. Okay. Someone asked if Stegosaurus could rear on its hind legs. We're going to get to that. Don't worry. I'll get there. Let me just finish this. So it could rotate on its front legs to swing around with that tail to keep predators at bay. So even though Stegosaurus was a pretty big animal and often has like a reputation of being kind of like slow and lumbering and cumbersome and long, you know, for long distances, it was not a fast runner by any means. But when it came to maneuvering itself in short quarters, it actually was pretty good. All right. The question was, again, could it rear up on its hind legs? The center of gravity was mostly in the hips, so it probably could. Okay. It wouldn't walk on its hind legs, but it could probably rear up, maybe support itself with the tail for short periods of time, maybe to like grab some leaves that were higher up. Okay. But it would have spent most of the time on its all fours. It wasn't like a duck-billed dinosaur where they could walk on their hind legs or all fours. Stegosaurus was primarily a quadruped walking on all fours, but it could occasionally get up on its hind legs if it wanted to. Okay, cool. So it's pretty neat about the front legs. Everyone always thinks about Stegosaurus with the spikes and the plates, but right off the bat, we just learned two new things about other body parts we don't even think about, the neck and the front legs. All right, so let's do the other leg. The other arm, I should say. So here's the elbow. Here's the this line is making it like the inside of the elbow, like this part of your elbow. Okay. Here's the wrist. And here's one claw. Here's two claws. This Stegosaurus is kind of going to be like on a hill going downwards, it looks like. All right. And then I'm going to fill out the belly, just like hadrosaurs. These guys had big bellies for digesting all that plant. Remember last week we talked about how plant-eating animals digest a lot of plants and need a lot of space in there to do that. Okay, there's some wrinkles up here. Now let's do the back leg. Here's the knee. Here's the beginning of the thigh. Here's the shin. Okay, and here's the foot. And Stegosaurus had three claws on the feet. And these claws were very like kind of stumpy and rounded. And then here's the bottom of the tail. The tail would have been very thick and muscular because it had to move around a lot. So that's important. And then let's see, let's do the top of the hips, the top of the back, the top of the shoulders. There we go. Top of the tail. Okay. Okay, cool. And then I'm going to take my eraser. I'm going to get rid of these extra lines here, my sketching lines. You can do that too if you did it with a pencil. If not, that's okay. It's not the end of the world. Not a big deal. Getting rid of the top there. Belly. Okay. Right. All right, looking good. Now, Stegosaurus's head, I cannot stress enough how small this thing's head.